Welcome to Talk Tennis, a podcast created specifically for you, the tennis fanatic. Join us each week as we work to elevate your game both on and off the court. We will deliver fresh episodes to keep you up to date with tennis trends and technologies, as well as exclusive interviews with industry experts, current and former pros, and so much more. Here's your host, Michelle.
Hello, Talk Tennis listeners. Today, we have another Beyond the Playtest episode for you. And this time, we're talking to our playtesters in California and Georgia, getting all their thoughts on the brand new Head Graphene 360 Plus Extreme Rackets, specifically the MP and Tour models. So let's go chat with some of our playtesters. We have Kristen and Eric with us all the way from Atlanta. Welcome, you guys. Thanks for joining me.
Thanks for having us.
Oh, jinx.
You guys are so in tune with each other. You guys both play tested the Head Graphene 360 Plus Extreme MP. So let's talk about that racket. And just to give you a rundown, they actually didn't know the specs as they were play testing, which I think is a good thing. But that is a 100 square inch racket with an 11.2 strung weight. It is 3 points headlight. The RA is at 66. The swing weight is at 325, which is pretty healthy. And it is a 16 by 19 string pattern. So the one note that I have in front of me is that, yes, the RA was slightly higher than the previous generation. And we will get into that a little bit in this episode, I think. But first things first, I wanted you guys to tell the listeners what racket is your current racket of choice and what your string of choice and string setup is.
Yeah, so I've kind of been in between the new, the Phantom 100X305 and the Prince Textream Tour 100P. Yeah, when we did a string play test a while back and I decided to string up the 100P. And ever since then, I've just kind of been keeping that in my bag and bringing it to the court. So that's kind of taken the lead on the Phantom just a little bit. So I've been playing mostly with the 100P and stringing it at 52 pounds with either Solinco Torbite or Hyper-G. I kind of go between the two.
Perfect.
Yeah, it's been an interesting couple of weeks for me. I don't know. I feel like I've kind of gone back and forth between like a couple rackets and just playing against like big hitters and, you know, trying to redirect their pace without, you know, staying in control of the point and making sure I'm not spraying balls long all the time. So I've been playing with a bit more like control oriented frames recently. So I've been playing with the Project 17, 16 by 19, and I've been playing with like Solinco Hyper G at around, I've been going at 53, but I kind of want to bump it up even higher just to get a little bit more control out of it. But I've also been actually gelling pretty well with the Head Prestige MP, the new Graphene 360 Plus. So, and I strung that one with Lynx Tour at 50 pounds.
Cool. Yeah.
It's been really good. Really plush. Like, really like the racket. So I've been really gelling with it.
With some of the other playtesters, they mentioned that Lynx Tour has become one of their go-to strings. And I don't know if you guys got to try the MP with Lynx Tour, the Extreme MP with Lynx Tour, but I know they tested it a little bit and enjoyed that. So first things first, I want your first impressions. What were your first thoughts the first time you hit with this racket?
I would say, obviously, it's a very spin-oriented racket, and that was key. You notice it from the back of the court that you're going to get the best out of the racket when you're loading it up with spin. Also on serves, could get really incredible spin on your serves. I also felt like my comments were probably going to be pretty similar to the previous model, with maybe just a little bit difference in feel. I definitely felt like this one played a little bit firmer than the previous one. But other than that, I did think the playability was pretty similar between the two from around the court.
Yeah, I would say, you know, it's an extreme. you're going to get a lot of power, a lot of spin. So from the back of the court, lots of power, lots of spin. Really love hitting like slices really easily. Just easy to get, easy depth. You can play with it a little bit more, you know, a huge sweet spot. So you can really dwell the ball on the string bed and get tons of spin out of that. And I really like it on volley. It's just really easy to volley with and stuff. So first impression, you know, I played with the extremes like pretty much my whole life. So it's pretty similar to what I remember. You know, lots of star, lots of spin, love volleys. And I can get more into that. Yeah, well, great.
What I remember. Perfect. So we'll get more into it and talk specifically about ground strokes and what you loved about it off the ground, what you maybe didn't like about it, if there were any issues, what was easy, what was hard, dive into that ground strokes.
Yeah. I would say, you know, when we were just drilling, I know it was last week, the other week, Eric and I were just playing a cross court game, and I just loved playing around with how much topspin I could put on the ball. I loved using slice. I loved coming to net. I thought I played really well at net. When we played, just yesterday, we played some more full court point games with serves. And I noticed that from the back of the court, I wasn't super confident on my ground strokes just because of the control aspect. I was afraid a little bit that I was going to overhit, especially if I wanted to flatten out the ball. It was easy to hit a little bit long there. And even when putting spin on the ball, I felt like it was just a little bit difficult to gauge the depth at times. So I noticed I was resorting to using more slice than I normally would just to get a little bit better control from the back of the court. So when I did like about it is that you do get that feel of feeling connected to the ball, hitting a heavier ball. And when you can load up that spin, you can get those balls landing right at the baseline pretty deep. So
nice.
Yeah. Like one thing with the extreme, I feel like you really have to commit. If you don't commit, I feel like it's just going to spray long a ton. So you just have to, you know, play like Rafa and really load up the spin monster, you know, Gasquet. But you know, you just really have to commit. And that is one thing I kind of struggled with from the back of the court at times. Like if I'm not feeling totally confident, like totally dialed in and really confident in my strokes, I just need to make sure I load the ball up with tons of spin and get below the ball and brush up. But you can definitely hit a super heavy ball. Like there's no doubt about it. But I definitely resorted to like slicing a lot more just because sometimes I would get a little conservative and be like, oh, like, am I going to miss this long? Am I not going to commit enough or hit enough spin and stuff? So I would kind of resort to more conservative slicing. But I like slicing. I mean, really deep balls, you can hit a ton of spin with it, you know? So maybe that's why.
That fits your game well.
Yeah. I mean, that's probably why I slice a lot. You know, I'm trying to kind of get away from that, trying to, you know, become a little bit more aggressive. But yeah, that's probably, you know, I love slicing with the extreme, and you can play with slices all you want, drop shot, you know, good feel. So yeah.
Nice. Hey,
that's about it.
That sounds like a winning combo. Yeah. I'm curious how you guys found it at the net. I'm always wondering how a racket is stability-wise up at the net. And then I'm also sort of curious if the Graphene 360 Plus made you feel like you were more connected to the ball, or maybe it was a more muted experience. So maybe you guys can talk about that.
I liked it on volleys, maybe even more so from the baseline. I thought it played, I thought it was stable. I was just looking at my comments from the previous model, and I said it had that backboard feeling of being able to get everything back. And I felt the same way with this racket, easy to put away volleys. I also felt like I had good touch. I don't know. I was thinking before too, that I didn't mention in first impressions, that I kind of feel like this would be a really good serve and volley racket. Just going back to Eric saying how the racket I felt like would fit your game. I see it fitting your game in that way as well. So I definitely felt, that volleys was a strong point for me on this playtest.
Nice.
Yeah, that's my favorite aspect of the frame. Just coming in that, and it's so easy to volley with. Like your sweet spot's huge. You can play with the volleys a lot, hit kind of weird spin on the ball. Like it's just a fun racket to volley with. You have so much variety. You can pretty much do whatever you want with it. Super easy to hit deep volleys, and I felt pretty connected as well, like on the string bed. So good touch, hit good drop shots, and put a little English on it if you want to. But no, it's a really easy racket to play with on my net. So yeah, it's great. That's my favorite. That's a highlight.
That's good to hear, because we get asked sporadically, like, what our favorite doubles rackets are. And it sounds like this one is turning out to be a solid doubles option. So with that being said, how was it when you went to serve?
Good kick serves. You know, you can just load up the ball spin, hit really great kick serves. I did struggle a little bit on the slice serves, just trying to get a little bit more of a slice instead of a kick. For whatever reason, it could just be probably just my technique, but I feel like the ball hops up a lot, you know, rather than maybe through the court on like second serve and stuff like that. But if you commit and you really want to hit a bomb, no problem. Okay. No problem. Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. I really liked it on serves. I felt connected to the ball. I thought putting spin on it was key. If I tried to flatten out the ball too much, I felt like my serves were going a bit long. but super spin friendly. And I agree with Eric, you do really have to commit. It's definitely a racket that if you're in a match play and you're starting to get a little tight on that second serve, it's not going to work to just push it back. You got to fully commit, fully swing through the ball. But yeah, I guess it's a good racket in that sense. It makes you really fully commit.
Go after
and,
it.
Yeah, exactly. So, and in doing that, I think you get really good results. So serves and volleys were definitely, I would say, my two strongest areas of this playtest.
Now, another obviously big part of doubles is returning. And oftentimes when a racket is loaded with power and spin, it can be hard to master that return and reel it in. How did you guys handle it when it was coming to returns? And how did this racket hold up against bigger servers?
I would say I agree with what you just said. It was kind of hard to reel it in because I like to go big on returns. And I felt like with this racket, I had to be a little bit more conservative. Even when I was trying to just like slice back really heavy serves, I felt like the ball could fly on me at times. And I wanted to swing through the ball. I wasn't fully confident swinging out. So I noticed that if I kind of shortened up my swing a little bit, I was getting better results on the return that way. But returns are my favorite part of the game. And it was one area that I never felt truly dialed in on with this racket.
Yeah. I would say it's a little bit harder to return when someone just kind of doesn't hit a ton of pace on the ball. So you're just kind of like, you're not like redirecting and just reacting off of instinct. You have to think of where you're going to hit the ball. And sometimes I feel like if my opponent was hit a little bit weaker of a second serve, I would struggle kind of finding my range. And I kind of found myself hitting the ball along a good amount. But, you know, chipping returns, it's really stable racket. So chipping returns, super easy. You can definitely be conservative and master your chip.
Head right now, I can see Eric like, yeah,
chip and charge.
Exactly, chip and charge, like all that. So yeah, there's no mistake that I played this for a while. Maybe I molded my game on it. but super easy to block balls back.
Well, here's a follow-up question then for you, Eric, because you're very familiar with this line. What is an extreme player from the past going to notice that's changed with this update?
I would say a little more power, to be honest. Okay. Like, I felt like there's just a little bit extra oomph. Maybe it's just me, like, I don't know.
Your game's
evolved.
I've just been like developing my game. I don't know. But I feel like it's a little bit more powerful than maybe the previous models. Maybe a little, maybe slightly more maneuverable as well.
Okay.
I would say that like I played with the rounder head shapes, like the, mm-hmm. when they had like the IG and the micro gels, and those were a little bit, It definitely takes some getting used to, like with those frames. But I did feel like when they made the head shape a little bit more oval, you know, that it did become a little bit more maneuverable and more like a standard, you know, racket that you'll find typically. So I feel like it might be a little bit more maneuverable than like previous models. Just my opinion.
No, I just pulled up the specs of the previous one or the current one that's getting phased out. And it does have a bit of a higher swing weight. So definitely more maneuverable, easier to load that ball with more power and pace and spin.
Yeah. But, you know, if you love the extremes, you're going to love this one. You know, I mean, it's an extreme. It's lots of power and spin.
I have a question that has nothing to do with playability, but I am curious what your guys' thoughts are on the new cosmetic. Do you like it?
I think it's pretty sick. The grip. Yeah, go ahead.
We're probably going to say the same thing with the green on the grip. Maybe it was like a little overkill. I don't know. But I saw pictures of it and I was thinking, I'm not sure. But when I saw it in person, I definitely liked it a lot better.
Yeah, the one thing, the grip. That's the only thing that I'm complaining about. But that's fine. Just put an overgrip on it, you'll be good.
Right.
But yeah. Cosmetic's good other than that. So.
Yeah, I like the updated cosmetic too.
Yeah.
So if you could pick the top three things that you liked best about this racket, what were they?
I would say access to spin, stable at net, and feeling well connected to the ball at net. And having that feeling of hitting a really heavy and spin-friendly serve.
Nice.
I would say good spin off the serves, good kick serves for doubles, especially slices. Again, are super easy to hit, as well as volleys. So it's just a really user-friendly racket. I feel like, mm-hmm. I feel like anyone can pretty much pick it up and play with it. Like it's just, yeah. So super user friendly, good spin on good kick and good spin on serves, etc. And just easy depth, easy to play with, and also feel connected to the ball. I feel like the feel is really good on this model, maybe compared to the previous model. Like, I feel like they definitely enhance the feel.
Yeah, I think I would say a lot of us have been enjoying the Graphene 360 Plus over previous versions of the Graphene 360 or even the Graphene. So
yeah,
I think that would sound about right. Do you have anything that stood out that you just did not like about this racket? Anything that was just a deal breaker or any small critique of it?
I tend to hit my ground strokes a little bit towards the upper hoop. And when I would get a little bit too far in that upper hoop, it would feel a little bit jarring. So a little bit, yeah, not so comfortable outside that sweet spot. I could just notice the firmness of the frame more so after playing in those moments where I hit that upper hoop, but then more so after playing. So a little bit firmer than I like to hit these days. These days, my rackets of choice are pretty flexible. So it's just probably a pretty big contrast for me.
Totally.
Yeah, I would say just unpredictable at times. Like if I was to play with it, I'd probably string it at like 60 pounds, to be honest, like just rein it in. Which is why, I did that in college, so not going to lie, but, it helped. It's just a little unpredictable at times. Other than that, I mean, I guess it's a little bit harder. Like if you want to just rip with someone from the back of the baseline, I feel like if someone's hitting a huge ball, it's a little harder to, rein in that, as I said, like rein in the power that's coming off of their racket. Kind of redirecting it. It's kind of tough. Like, I feel like I would just overhit a lot and kind of just spray.
Yeah.
But maybe I just need to hit the ball earlier. So that's probably part of it. But, that's what I would say.
Well, you mentioned string at 60. What did you guys have any favorite string setups that you guys got to try or anything that you going further, if you were to continue playing with this racket, what string setup would you use? Because I'm all about that rein in the control with that string at 60 pounds.
Totally.
So I feel ya.
Yeah.
We have it strung up at 52 right now. Okay. I think we have Torbite in there, but I think we'll probably end up putting some Lynx Tour in there and see how that plays.
Yeah.
I know Britt and Jay really were enjoying Lynx Tour.
Yeah, it's a really good string. Like, that's like top three strings for me for sure.
Nice.
Yeah, I love it. It's really nice. Yeah, I mean, for me, I guess like, I'd probably try to go higher. I mean, I love Hyper G, so I'd probably just try to, I'd bump it up to like 60 pounds and try to just get all that control. I don't know. It could be kind of sick. I just try it out.
Try it out.
Yeah. But right now we have it. Yeah. As Kristen said, strung with tour by it a little lower, like 53.
Yeah. And I guess that's a good opportunity to let our listeners know. We mention this often, but we always try to string up our playtest rackets with a string that we're all really familiar with and at attention that makes everyone happy. So with so many different players and so many different, preferences, most of the time our strings are at 52 pounds to start. And usually it's a string that we're all very, very familiar with. And then we go from there. So good opportunity to see how it feels and then adjust accordingly.
Exactly.
Now, what kind of player would you recommend this racket for? And if you think of it, what rackets are comparable? So what kind of player could you see switching into this racket? And what racket were they maybe using before this?
I would say Eric. I go back to what I said. I do think it's a good serve and volley racket. And as you mentioned, therefore also a good doubles racket.
Mm-hmm.
So someone who likes to play with a lot of spin, maybe play with a lot of slice, charge the net, Eric.
Yep. That's about right. Yeah, I would say the same thing. Yeah, just a good player likes to really like crash the net really hard. certain volley a lot, like hit good kick serves and dubs, like can just really get your opponent like to the fence, and stuff like that. So Yeah. Mm-hmm. And also, like, if you like to kind of, like, lob a lot, like, lob off returns and come in, like, yeah.
That's the fun. So as I say, so you got to have a little more dimension to your game, yeah, maybe, to fully appreciate what the extreme MP has.
Maybe. I mean, I mean, it's, you know.
Put some extreme dynamics into your game.
Yeah. 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 I think this is my last question. And we get asked to compare rackets a lot. And leading up to this, the extremes have always looked like another racket on the market. So the obvious question is, how does this racket compare to the Babolat Pure Aero? Maybe it's been a while since you've hit that racket.
It has been. But from what I remember, I would say it has a little bit, like, I feel like I get a little bit more control out of the Pure Aero. Like, I can kind of, like, I feel like I can dial it back. And, you know, I can load it up with crazy spin, good power, but I just feel like there's that little bit, like, there's a little bit of a gap, like a bridge where you can kind of be like, okay, like, I'm going to take a step back and, you know, just try to see how many balls I can make. I don't know. I feel like it's a little bit less, I feel like the Pure Aero is a little bit more predictable, in my opinion.
Okay.
Yeah. Just a little bit more consistent. So,
because you know, yeah, we're going to get that question.
Yeah. Yeah. Just, yeah, just my personal opinion. Extremes, I played with the Extreme. It's a good racket. But I just think, you know, the Pure is a little bit more predictable. And,
yeah. Yeah. Turns out Eric is the new spokesman for the Extreme, yeah, MP. Oh, awesome. Anything else that you guys want to add about this playtest or this racket?
Not that I can think of.
You guys want to give me a shout out on anything that you're playtesting right now that we can look forward to seeing soon?
We're playtesting some Yonex shoes right now.
Nice.
So the PC Eclipsion 3.
Have you been wearing them? Do you like them?
Yes, I do.
I'm a little jealous.
There's some positives and there's some negatives.
Okay, well, I believe it.
But, yeah, they're pretty comfortable. I like them. They're good shoes. Yeah.
They were more on the narrow side, right? No, just kidding. I was like, because I know you have a narrow
foot. I know the last one, I've playtested the Eclipsion 2s, and I remember those had a really snug mm-hmm. fit. And these are definitely a little bit more forgiving in the 4 foot.
Oh, interesting.
And I'm actually having some issues where I'm sliding around a little bit in the shoe. So
I was just saying yesterday, it seems like every summer there's this weird little, like, part of playtesting where nothing is exactly perfect. And you don't have, like, a really positive, like, 100%, like, oh, I love that product. And I'm also in that little, like, section right now. Like, shoes, it's been rough.
Yeah, been rough shoes now. Are difficult. I mean, they're going to fit everyone a little bit differently. And it probably is affecting that we're playing outside now in high humidity and all that stuff plays into it. So, yeah. And then we're going to start playtesting a string soon. We haven't strung it up yet, though. Dunlop Explosive Bin, that's on deck. So, yeah.
Nice. Well, thank you guys for talking to me about the Extreme MP. Loved hearing from you guys.
Thanks.
Next up, let's go check in with Jason, Tiffany, and Brittany in California and see what they think of the new Extreme MP and Tour. So to start, I'm going to have each one of the playtesters that is with me right now introduce themselves and then give you their current racket of choice and their favorite string setup at the moment. So who wants to start?
It's tough. I think I'm in between rackets again.
Uh-oh.
My current one is the Wilson Clash 100, but I've been very much enjoying the, can we sneak peek this? The Prince Twist Power 100? Yeah. That one's nice, and I'm really digging it. So kind of going to be playing around with some weights because it's a little light, like 10.8 ounces strung, but I'm liking it a lot.
Nice. And do you have a favorite string setup?
String-wise, actually, one of my current faves is the Lynx Tour.
Nice.
I really like that string right now. So yeah, I would say that's probably my current favorite.
Cool.
All right, I guess I'll go. This is Tiffany here. And I've been playing with the same racket for a number of years now. It's the Prince Techstream Tour 100P. I'm always messing around with my string setups, but one I like to fall back on is a hybrid of ALU Power and Head Reflex MLT, 50, 52 pounds.
Cool.
I'll wrap it up. Brittany here. I am currently in between two rackets. I've been using the Yonex E-Zone 100 for the last 8 years, the different iterations. And the newest one came out in January, and I'm slowly transitioning to that one from the previous model. But I am keeping a little bit of my options open for the new Pure Drive coming out. And as far as string, I always just go back to my go-to Vocal Cyclone at 53 pounds, 54. But I've also liked the hybrid Vocal V-Fuse, which has a natural gut. So I've been dabbling in that as well.
Cool. So all of these playtesters have hit significantly with these new extremes, both the MP and the Tour. So I'm just going to run down the specs real quick. We'll start with the MP, which is coming in at 11.2 ounces strong, 3 points headlight. The RA is at 66, 325 swing weight, and a 16 by 19 string pattern. With this MP, the one note that I have is that it's a slightly higher RA than the previous version. However, we know that that Graphene 360 Plus has been feeling really nice in all the rackets that we've tried it in. So maybe you guys can speak a little bit on that. I do want to run down the Tour specs real quick. 11.4 ounces strong, 6 points headlight, 66 RA, 318 swing weight, 16 by 19 string pattern. This is a new model, a new mold, and the beam is thinner than typical modern players' rackets, and it has that dynamic string pattern. So tighter in the middle for more control, and then a little more open on the outside of that sweet spot. So let's go first impressions right off the bat. Did you guys have one that you liked more than the other, one that you gelled with right off from their first hit, or any opinions?
I have to say, I was when I first picked up the Tour, since it's new, I guess it was a surprise. I was expecting, coming from the Extreme line, I was really expecting lots of free power, really easy access to spin, and it was a lot more control oriented than I expected. It took me probably just a couple hours, and then I really, really enjoyed it, but just a big surprise coming from previous Extremes, and it was just a definitely more control oriented feel than I had been accustomed to with the Extreme line.
Nice.
We kind of got a sneak peek of it about a year ago, and it was just a blacked out racket with a bunch of other head models. And I immediately had gravitated towards it without even knowing what it was, the Extreme Tour. And so I was really excited when we finally got our samples, as the Extreme line is probably my favorite of the headlines. So I immediately gravitated towards that Tour again and really, really liked it. And then luckily I was on both playtests in the Mid Plus, and I've been kind of going back and forth between which one I like. But like Tiffany said, it's much more control oriented. It was really nice when I was playing matches or point play, I could be a little bit more precise with my shots. Whereas the Mid Plus I found was more of a fun racket for me to practice with. It was easy depth, easy power, easy spin.
And I guess that's something I actually forgot to mention is the head size between the MP and the Tour. So we have a 98 square inch with the Tour and 100 square inches with the MP.
When I started hitting with them side by side, I kind of liked the Tour first. And I was like, wow, this is so easy. I picked it up. It was easy to swing. And it was just fun to hit with. And then as the playtest kind of went on, I'm kind of liking the MP more. I found like I can just put away shots easier with it. It's more free power. Launch angle is a little bit higher, and I tend to launch the ball a little bit more with MP, but I'm just winning points easier with MP versus the Tour. If I could be in the lab and kind of help tweak the Tour, I would say that it's either a little bit too headlight, and assuming it's a little bit too low, combined with a thinner beam, makes it a little underpowered for me. I would have liked a little bit more power, but yeah, it is, like I mentioned, much more control-oriented than Extreme rackets of the past. So that was definitely a fun one to try.
Cool. So let's get deep into the playtest. If you were to talk about ground strokes with these rackets, compare it to maybe your racket of choice, how it's different, which one you preferred, what you found it did best off the ground. If there was anything that it didn't do well off the ground, feel free to mention that also. Who wants to start? I feel like I have to call people out.
I can start. Typically, I would say coming from my racket to an Extreme racket, there's quite a big jump. My racket is an 18 by 20. It's a fairly open 18 by 20 string patterned racket, and on the more powerful side for 18 by 20. But that being said, it's nowhere near something like the Extreme Mid Plus, for example. But to the Tour model, I thought it was pretty comparable. The Tour swings maybe a little bit faster than my Prince racket, but the level of control was comparable. For me, I think the standout feature was the control. I did notice that I needed to be swinging full out. If I were taking a stab at the racket or at a ball with the tour racket model, I wasn't getting that same, oh, it's just going to go over and keep me in the point quite as long. I did need to be making sure that I was really taking a full cut to get it if I was out of position. That's where the mid plus was a little bit more fun and kept me in the points longer, because we all know I'm not the person who is hitting winners all day. My objective is to keep you running around as long as possible. So that was the control and the spin were the standout features for me at the baseline. Like Jay said, I guess like if it's off center, it's lacking a little bit of that power. So, I mean, you know, it's a give and take. You get the control, but you don't get the free power.
Nice. Makes sense. Brittany, how did you find these rackets to play from the ground?
I found that the Tour and the Mid Plus, my racket of choice, the Ezone 100, kind of fits right in between them as far as how I felt it played on the baseline. The Mid Plus has a little bit more easy power for me, a little bit easier spin. And then the Tour had a little bit more control compared to my racket of choice. And really, it's just kind of that matter of what I was feeling that day, what I was needing. If I was needing that little bit extra power, that Mid Plus was so easy to just go to and just swing away. And then if I needed to be a little bit more precise, I was leaning towards the Tour. And I think that in terms of like slice, I like the Tour, but I think Jay had mentioned I needed maybe a little bit more weight to get a good like knifing slice.
Mm-hmm. Jay, how about you?
Yeah, I'd say the Tour, I think, is a easier swinging racket. They're both fairly user-friendly. I like that the Mid Plus is the swing weight's a little bit more manageable now compared to the previous version. Mm-hmm. The previous one, the swing weight was in the 330s, which gave it a lot of power and pop, but it's a little bit high for me. I know you like them in the high 330s, low 340s maybe, but it was a little high for me. So I like that it was dialed down a little bit. Between the two, yeah, the Tour is just, it was tough to slice with. My slices kind of tend to float a little bit. Mm. But they're both great access to spin. So that was, I mean, for me, that's a big part of my game. So I really like that. The open stream pattern was nice.
Now I know with the addition of Graphene 360 Plus, at least with the speed models and the prestiges, we've really seen the stability of these rackets kind of go up a little bit. So how did they play at the net for you guys? And how was the stability and the accuracy? And did you prefer one or over the other at net?
Net? What's that? Do people go? Is that a thing? So she just go up there to shake hands?
Racket tap nowadays, post-COVID.
Oh, yeah. That, huh? Maybe Brittany.
Yeah, Britt. Let us know.
Well, let's see. Michelle and I, we played doubles a couple weeks ago, and I grabbed that first. So really got to get kind of right into the mix of it with how it performed at net with volleys. We were playing against Chris and Gran. So definitely a lot of volleys coming our way. I thought that the Tour did a good job of, it was really easy to get in place. I had really quick reflexes. Now, is it the most stable? No, but I wasn't expecting it to be. It did the job for the most part, just a couple times when I was reaching or I had a real one that was being hit pretty hard at me and I wasn't hitting in the sweet spot. I could feel a little bit of shaking, but for the most part, I was really able to kind of stand my ground and hit both offensive and defensive volleys. I will note, I did like the feel of this Extreme more than previous versions, as well as other head rackets in the past. And I think Head's been doing a good job at getting better feel, and especially on like shorter pickup volleys. So I liked that aspect to up at net.
Okay, Tiff, yeah. How did it go for you at the net?
Well, like Jay, not often the place you're going to find me. I do come forward. I mean, it's not my most comfortable area of the court because maybe some people have noticed I'm not the tallest person. So often I come to the net and then I'm running back to chase the lob. But at net, I really did appreciate the quickness of the racket. And if I were punching the volley, I got some good depth and good pace. But it's one of those where it is a little bit headlight and, you know, I just really needed to stick that volley if I wanted a nice stable feel. When I was hitting off center, like off the stretch, it really wasn't giving me a lot of free stuff. So it's a racket that definitely rewarded me when I was on my game and let me know when I was a little bit off. But I really did enjoy it, and I thought it was comfortable for me, and really loved that we had a quarter grip size to play test. So that's always a plus for me.
Whoop, whoop.
Jason, do you want to skip right to serves?
Sure. Yeah. Serves. Comparing the two between the tour and the MP, it's kind of, I think you pick what you want more out of your racket and what you're looking for. I think with the tour, it's a very easy swinging racket. I found like I could easily kind of replicate my serve so I can get a kind of higher serving percentage. Mm-hmm. It wasn't the most powerful. I think my own racket I'm hitting bigger serves with versus the tour. But with the MP, I'm getting more pop, but it's also a little bit more sluggish. Mm-hmm. And I'm not generating as much racket head speed, so I'm not getting as much spin. So it just kind of depends on your game. If you're like one, if you're really wanting power and you're not really expecting to put a lot of racket head speed into your serve, then MP probably. But if you want more control and easier to generate a swing and accelerate through contact, then the tour is a better call.
Britt, how do you feel on serves?
Yeah, I was pleasantly surprised with actually the amount of power I was able to get from the tour. The serve's not normally my biggest strength. I'm more of a returner. But I did find, especially like when we were playing doubles, I was getting a bunch of free points. I was able to place it fairly accurately. Because of that low swing weight, I could get my racket speed going, and I didn't get any arm fatigue having to serve over and over again. And I thought there was decent spin as well. So I was able to be effective on my serve with the tour. When it came to serving with the mid plus, I did like easy power, easy spin. The swing weight is a little bit higher, but I didn't feel that slowed me down in any way. I thought maybe my precision was maybe not as strong as with the tour, but I was still able to get free points. So honestly, I kind of what Jay said, it just depended what I was needing that day. If I was needing a little bit more power, and I lean towards the mid plus as a serving racket, but the tour did the job just fine as well.
Tiff, what do you think?
Spin was definitely the thing I noticed. I'm not always getting the racket head speed I need to get good spin on my serves, but this racket was coming overhead really nicely. So I really enjoyed it in that sense. And it, like Britt said, it was also very easy to swing. And so I wasn't getting tired when I was serving. And then wanted to mention too, like just because I found it was to be a little bit more on the control oriented side, we had a couple different polys in there, and I really gravitated toward the 17 gauge over the 16 gauge. Mm. It just upped that power level just a little bit. And I found like that once I started hitting with the racket that had the 17 gauge string in it, it was really enjoying it. And that was like my sweet spot right there.
Nice. Now let's talk about returns, Britt. I know this is your area of choice and your favorite spot on the court. I'm curious to hear which one you preferred when it came to returning, whether it was a big return or when you were getting a big first serve and you just kind of had to block and be a little more defensive.
Yes, returning is more my forte than serving. And this was tough because I don't know if I can pick a winner. Like I was able to get enough power and I was able to block the ball back well with the Extreme Tour. I had some good returns when we were playing doubles, and same when I was playing some singles points as well. I felt pretty confident with where I was aiming, and so I could be focused more on my targets, which was nice. But the mid plus did offer that nice solid feel. And when I was blocking it back, I just had to be careful not to overhit it at times. It was once I got the racket around the body moving, if I took too big of cut, I could overhit. So I think I might lean towards the tour for returns, even though the swing weight's a little bit lower. I was grooving more with that.
Jerry, what about you?
Opposite. I like the MP more. I just like that I could be more aggressive and attack more with it. And then when I was blocking shots back, it was easier to get depth with and then kind of hit a neutral ball and then kind of recover and then get ready for the next shot. So the tour, I could see that if players are like playing doubles, something that I don't do. if you like it for like hitting angles, angled returns. But for me, I like the power and the accessibility of the power with MP over the tour.
That's what I like to do a lot in doubles is low angled ground strokes. So the tour definitely wins in that book.
How about you, Tev? How'd it work?
You know, I wasn't on the playtest of the mid plus, so I did hit with it off the ground, but I wasn't playing points with it. But with the tour, it falls into what I like from a racket. It offers a little bit of power, but more control. So I found that I was able to swing out if I wanted to because of the maneuverability and kind of just pick my spots. If I really wanted to try to aim for the corners, if I was feeling good that day, it let me do that and do it with precision. And I had no issues with comfort or stability, really. You know, you do lose a little bit of power outside of the sweet spot, but that's to be expected with any racket, really. So I thought it was quite comparable to my racket as far as control levels.
Now, I want to ask you guys what your favorite thing about these rackets were and what your least favorite thing was, but this has nothing to do with the playability. I'm curious to hear what you guys think about the cosmetic. Do you like it? Do you not like it?
It grows on you.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah. I think it's like you see it and you're like, whoa, there's a bright yellow grip. But it blends well with the racket. It just all kind of flows in. So I think it grows on you.
Nice. Any other opinions?
Being a fan of neon colors, it definitely, I liked it a lot. I thought it was, for me, it's one of the best cosmetics, I think, of the Extreme line. It's pretty clean, but still has the nice pop of yellow and gray. So I was a big fan.
Yeah, I liked it too. I mean, I liked it. Initially, I was like a little unsure. And then I saw it. Actually, I came down and Britt was finishing up a hitting session and she was out on court with it. And I was like, you know, that does. It looks really good. It flows. So it took me a little bit, but I've come around and I think it's a sharp looking racket.
Yeah. I like that it doesn't look like any other rackets on the market at the moment, you know, so that's kind of cool.
Yeah. Yeah, it is definitely unique.
Yeah, the gray sets it apart for sure.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So what was your favorite part of the playtest? Favorite stroke, favorite area of the court, favorite any of the above?
Oh, for me, backhand cross court all day.
All day. Tiff's got that backhand cross court all day.
No, I mean, I don't quite have the dipper angle of that Brit, the two-handed short backhand cross court, but I can dream and practice. But I love to hit that cross court backhand with the tour.
Yes. Jay, favorites?
Favorite on the for the tour, my forehand. but surprisingly, for the MP, I'd say probably my backhand. With a higher swing weight, I don't hit as much power on my backhand side. So it was just nice to be able to just take an easy swing at it, but still get good depth and good spin on it. So for the mid plus, I like my backhand on it.
Britt, what were your favorite parts of both the rackets?
So for the mid plus, I'm going to do a generalize of my defensive shots because I found when I was playing and like I was on the defense or maybe not able to hit an offensive shot, the racket did a really good job of getting the ball back deep in the court with a decent amount of power and spin to keep me either in a neutral or even possibly transition to an offensive position, which was really, really nice when I'm not maybe moving as well as I used to. So I'm a little slower. So it was nice to kind of depend on the racket a little bit. And then as far as the tour, that's a tough one. I definitely probably would say my angled return on that one. I had nice spin, good control, and I was able to be pretty precise on it. So
nice. Now, if there was anything that you didn't like or something that you would change, let's hear it. Tiff, we'll start with you.
I think I kind of mentioned it. It was a little lower powered than I had expected with as an extreme. And so I don't know that that's a dislike or more or less just an expectation that I had, a preconceived notion. So I guess there's that. And that really is it. I mean, it took me some adjustment time. And I think that part of it is just my mindset going in saying, hey, I'm going to hit an extreme. And with my past experiences with extreme, I had this idea that I was just going to get loads of power and spin. Spin was definitely there. Power was there when I needed to generate it, but I needed to generate it myself. And so like I had said, for me, it was finding that a different string setup than we initially had in it.
Makes sense. Jay, what about you?
Yeah, I agree with Tiff. I think with the tour, it's slightly underpowered. So, and maybe a little bit light. So you could add a little bit of weight to it, into the hoop, up the swing weight, up the overall weight. And then, yeah, I'd probably string it in the low 50-pound range just to up the power a bit. But Yeah, I think that's my biggest gripe with the tour. With the MP, really nothing too big. It's a pretty solid feeling racket. The swing weight's now brought down to the mid 320s. So that was, I think that was my one of my biggest things with the previous version, was the swing was just a bit high. Now it's right in my wheelhouse.
So they say. Britt, any critiques on either racket?
I had pretty similar feedback to Tiff and Jay. I probably would bump the swing weight just slightly on the tour racket up. It is a little odd that it's lighter, or it's a lower swing weight than the mid plus, as I'd feel like the tour with a 98 square inch head size should have a higher swing weight that could benefit just the overall play of the racket. But I guess it leaves room, like Jay said, for customization for someone to come in and mess around with the swing weight and the balance point. And then for the mid plus, gosh, there was not really much I disliked. Being very, very critical, I'd say, while I do think the feel's improved, it's still compared to some of the other racket brands that I lean towards, I prefer their feel, like Yonex, Prince, and Babolat. So, but that's just personal.
Yeah, totally. I understand what you're saying, though. Who would you recommend these rackets to? What rackets on the market would you compare them to? Is there anything that you've hit with lately that is kind of in the same boat? Or is there a certain type of player that you really think should be demoing these?
I think these are for the modern player that likes to attack, to hit with spin. What's it comparable to? I think the Tour is somewhat comparable to like the Vocal V-Cell 9 or a stiffer version of the Clash-ish, okay, where it's very, very easy to swing, easy to generate racket head speed, just a very easy racket to use, which is very much like the Clash, but yeah, totally different feel. Mm-hmm. But playability-wise, it's similar.
I'm gonna ask the question because I know a lot of our listeners probably will ask this. How would it compare to, and let's take the MP. How would the MP compare to a Pure Aero?
I mean, I did allude to the feel is a little bit different. Babolat's the Pure Aero feel, I'd say maybe it's also slightly more spin friendly, just slightly if I had to compare the two, and maybe a little whippier through the air, especially the mid plus. And what it would compare to the Tour, I actually also thought of the Pure Aero VS. I feel like that could be a comparable racket. It's maybe a little lighter swing wise, but kind of the same that when I play tested the Pure Aero VS, I kind of liked it. Well, the Pure Aero VS, it took me a little bit of time to really appreciate it, whereas the Extreme Tour, I appreciated it right away. Now, I don't know if it's because I had play tested the Pure Aero VS and was used to that, but yeah, I'd say they have similarities for sure.
Was there any special string setup or strings that you really felt made these rackets shine? Tiff, you can start out.
You know, I really, we had the Lynx Tour in there at 16, and I really actually do like that string. I just felt that the gauge wasn't quite right for the Tour. Mm-hmm. And we ended up using some Slinko Confidential at 17 in there. But I really just think that I liked the thinner gauge, or possibly if it were a 16 gauge going with a lower tension than our typical 53 pounds would have been better for me. But definitely, it wasn't necessarily just because it was a different string, because I really do like the Lynx Tour. I think if that were in there with a 17 gauge and 50 to 52 pounds, I would have enjoyed it just as much as I was enjoying the Confidential. It's just more elasticity out of the thinner string.
Nice.
Agree. Nothing else to add. Lynx Tour feels good, really good in that racket.
I know we had a bunch of different string setups in both the Mid Plus and the Tour, and I obviously always gravitate towards the Cyclone, which we had strung up in one of them, and I thought it played nicely. But I was surprised that Lynx Tour played really well. I was actually liking it in the racket as well.
Sweet. Well, I think that wraps up this episode. Thank you guys so much for joining me and diving deeper into the playtest. So if anyone out there has any questions specifically for these playtesters, feel free to leave us a comment or reach out to us at podcast@tennis-warehouse.com. And be sure to watch and read our full review on our website. Thanks so much for listening. Make sure to rate and review this podcast wherever you download your episodes. And be sure to visit our websites for all of the tennis deals at tenniswarehouse.com, tenniswarehouseeurope.com, and tennisonly.com.au. Hope you enjoyed this episode, and until next time, happy hitting.
I'm sorry.
Someone's got like construction going on in their office.
What is that?
It's got to be me because I'm sitting closest to the thing. They're like picking up and dropping
and
stuff
I'm like,
off. And...
Oh God! Every time I talk, it's like the warehouse all over again.
It's totally fine because hopefully we can like take that out. But it's just really funny. We should just record on the tennis court. It'll be just as loud.
Whoop whoop.
It's like you knew.
Oh, this is going to be fun to edit.
Sorry.
Have fun editing this one.
That's okay. This is why we don't do things on Mondays.
Okay.
My fault. Here we go.
Okay.
We got this.